Hi, this is Nevin Mann. I'm founder and chairman of the Johnson Woodford Company, a management consulting firm dedicated to helping companies in the death care industry improve management of their operations and to improve and sustain their long-term profitability. This is part B of video one, the executive summary of our approach to using the balanced scorecard methods for implementation-focused strategic planning. You can also download the complete PowerPoint version from our website, johnsonwoodford.com. The balanced scorecard is a no-nonsense approach to strategic planning that focuses on action, implementation, and individual accountability. Unlike traditional time-consuming planning, where the end product is the plan itself, our end product is action, the approach is dynamic, meaning that things change and the plan changes to keep pace in real time. This video covers the 7 implementation steps of our balanced scorecard approach to strategic planning. Implementing the balanced scorecard uses much of the existing work already done by most organizations. For example, the first 2 balanced scorecard steps are identical to traditional strategic planning. The first step, defining vision and mission, is important to assure senior management and key stakeholders are in alignment. The second step, goal and objective definition, has the same purpose, alignment. In the balanced scorecard, we include defining performance measures as part of defining objectives to be sure the objectives have been clearly stated and that there is a common understanding of expected outcomes. Trends, step 3, in the traditional planning are simply opportunities and threats. We use a single classification, trends, to simplify information collection regarding outside factors. Also, using a single classification adds a sense of neutrality that keeps us from prejudging the effects of outside factors. Challenge analysis is our approach to looking at strengths and weaknesses. But instead of focusing on good and bad, or strengths and weaknesses, the balanced scorecard looks at every significant process and determines its importance to the organization's overall success. Then, there is an assessment of how well each process is being carried out. Using this approach, rather than just strengths and weaknesses, helps us focus on priorities. In priority order, important things that need to be fixed, rather than looking at weaknesses where everything looks like it needs to be fixed. The first 4 steps of the balanced scorecard are things that you are already likely doing. Therefore, employing the balanced scorecard process to this point is not added work. It's just looking at the planning process from a different and new perspective. One result of the balanced scorecard approach is less prejudgment, more open communication, less defensiveness, better understanding of the organization, and a clearer look at issues needing to be addressed. The next step, guiding principles, is not typically found in the strategic planning process, but it is the point where the balanced scorecard begins to differentiate itself from traditional strategic planning. It is the area where the development of human capital is highlighted. Guiding principles are statements of our expectations about individual, group, and company behaviors and mores. Guiding principles provide a platform for communication of vision, mission, goals, and objectives, and are key ingredients to linking individual performance to overall expected results. The first 5 steps of the balanced scorecard are mostly analytical and setting the course for the organization. They tend to be static and change infrequently. The last 2 steps are action and results-oriented. They are dynamic and ongoing. These are the management tools that tie everything together. Initiatives and the initiatives portfolio is where the balanced scorecard departs in a major and important way from traditional strategic planning. This is the implementation phase. Not a one-time shot or mere listing in general terms of what needs to be done, but specifics with timelines not typical of traditional planning approaches. The difference is that initiatives have the following characteristics. first. Any initiative, any issue needing attention can result in an initiative. Anyone, staff member, supplier, stakeholder, executives, or board member could write an initiative. Initiatives are described in terms of their value, the risk, their cost, return on investment, time frame, milestones, and accountability. They're dynamic and they frequently change as things are accomplished or as the situation changes. The portfolio of initiatives ties all significant activity together and provides a simple means to keep priorities visible and top of mind. The final step in the balanced scorecard process is completing custom-designed scorecards to show plan information and initiatives from different perspectives. Simple spreadsheets are used to capture information about goals, objectives, process improvement, end results, and accountability, and to array this information for real-time management of plan implementation. With three or four spreadsheets, managers can tell at a glance where they stand and how they are doing. Developing graphic schedules helps raise awareness of major milestones and identify project conflicts and help with decisions on resource allocation. Some of the more important benefits of using this balanced scorecard approach over other planning methods are that the balanced scorecard puts existing information to work. The balanced scorecard brings to life the work previously done in other strategic planning exercises and makes it useful. Action priorities are established, making it easier to focus on implementation. Plans become dynamic as a result of flexible timeframes and by tying initiatives and action plans back to organization goals. Communication improves as a result of clear priorities and focus. Decision-making is easier and more transparent because there's a common language of initiatives that gets everybody on the same page. Motivation and participation is higher because everyone has a clear line of sight from their roles to the overall organization goals. The balanced scorecard creates a performance-centered culture based on teamwork. We hope you found this video helpful in your understanding of our balanced scorecard approach to strategic planning. We have additional videos in the works which describe each of the seven steps in more depth and detail. Be sure to visit our website for additional information or call us anytime with your questions and feedback. Thank you for your time.